Hello and welcome back, or welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Alice. I do vlogs and reaction videos. This is my reaction to Speak Now's Taylor's version. Basically, I grew up with this album. First of all, it mothered me. Okay, I was 10, I think. Let's see. Yeah, 25th of October 2010. So yeah, I was 10 already by then. 10-year-old me loved Taylor already back then. To the point where I got a detention, or I was in what, year three schooling system here in Australia. I won't go into the schooling system. So we wouldn't call it detention. You had to sit in the classroom with the teacher for 5 minutes of lunchtime, and lunchtime was 20 minutes. So it was a big deal. Is because another girl, I can't even remember her name now, she bitch slapped me first, and I bitch slapped her in self-defense, but that's a whole other story. We were fighting, literally, over whether Speak Now or Fearless, the original version back then, obviously, just which one was better. And I said Speak Now was better than Fearless back then. And it's actually quite funny now that they're both being re-recorded. Fearless was my, like, first album that I ever listened to of Taylor, because I was only, what, six? Yeah, I was six when the debut came out. It was Fearless. It was my second CD. I'll say that, because my first ever CD that I bought was actually One of the Boys, Katy Perry's album. Then my second CD was Fearless. I didn't own Speak Now, the CD version. I actually bought it on iTunes, because that's after they introduced, like, oh, you can buy music on iTunes now. So, like, there's no point for CDs. So Taylor always has a special place in my heart, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. I don't know. Sad to see an era go, but like, I'm like, my childhood, you know? Sorry. Just the mature voice of, you know, a 30-year-old re-recording her stuff when she was like, what, 18 or 19 or 20 or whatever. It's just, Oh, so much childhood. You were with college, making time, reading tables. Oh my god. Look back. Okay. There's a risk. What is that fear of falling? Oh my god. Yes. Oof, I love it. I can see it now. Amazing. Tears in by the water. Really on the run. This time. This daughter. My best thing that's ever been. Oh, just hits so different now. This video would be way too long if I did the whole entire song, so I'm just gonna go up to the choruses of each song, because it's gonna take way too long and this is gonna take forever to edit. But that was mine. Amazing. Okay, Sparks Fly. Ooh, that's different. That's like really different, right? I can't tell. I haven't listened to the original version of Speak Now for ages. Because I would always go to other albums, by the way. I'd like go to Fearless, Taylor's version, or Red's Taylor version, or Reputation. Reputation's like my fave. So I'm excited for re-recording of that. But yeah, I don't really play much songs on Speak Now, even though it was like my album growing up, I guess. I don't know. I only play it for nostalgia reasons. So I think that's why I can't tell the difference whether it's like changed or not, like sort of, but anyway.
To hope you could see what I was thinking
everything now. Meet me in the pouring rain. I keep forgetting. Americans call it sidewalk. We call it footpath. Just putting it out there. Anyway, continue. Wow. Oh my god. That's amazing. Ah, so much childhood. Okay, next one is Back to December. Sounds kind of different. I'm so glad you made time to see me. How's life? Tell me, how's your family? Oof. I haven't seen them in a while. This hits so different now that she's re-recording this and you know it's about Taylor Lautner. It's just weird. Anyway. You've been good, busier than ever. We small talk, work and the weather. Your guard is up and I know why. Because the last time you saw me is still burned in the back of your mind. You gave me roses. Yeah. Oh, jeez. So this is me swallowing my pride, standing in front of you, saying I'm sorry. Yeah, so this is like an apology song almost. Huh. Okay. And I go back to December all the time. Hmm. I'm pretty sure Taylor Lautner is now married, isn't he? To someone. I can't be bothered Googling it, but anyway. I go back to December, turn around and make it all right. Ooh. I go back to December all the time. Hey, Chris. Bells. Speak now. Girl, who should be rudely barging in on a white veil occasion, but you, I'm not the kind of boy you should be marrying the wrong girl. Oh my god, yes. I'm and see your friends and her snotty little family all dressed in pastel. And it's weird that she's re-recorded this, but anyway, also, this is... None of my family watch my YouTube videos, so thank God for this. But, like, this kind of also just reminds me of my cousin's wedding. Because, honestly, whatever. She married the wrong guy, if you ask me. I know, she's divorced with two kids, but that's a whole other story. Is yelling at a bridesmaid. A gown shaped like a pastry. So is this basically saying, isn't this song like, because I don't remember most of these songs as a child because I was what, 10, but isn't this like saying, oh, don't marry him, he's no good for you, you could do better kind of song? Huh, interesting. Oh, okay. Woo. That just brings up so many memories. But that I can relate to that song because I know people who have gotten married to the wrong type of people. Anyway. Next one is Dear John. Oh god, John Mayer can go and he's still a dick. Well, I mean, he's less of a dick now because he was like, he even said when this was re-recorded, he said something about being kind or something and don't hate on him, whatever. I'm just like, you know what you did. I mean, would have, could have, should have, just explains it all. Like, just, ugh, whatever. It hits so different now. So different. Especially after listening to Would've, Could've, Should've. You know what I mean? Like, it... And you know it's about John Mayer. It's just... It hits so... raw, I guess. Is what I'm trying to say. I like the plucky guitar. And it's 6 minutes. 6:45. Long were the nights when my... these once revolved around you. Counting my footsteps, praying the floor won't fall through. Yeah, going back to praying again, would've, could've, should've. All I used to do is pray, would've, could've, should've. Yeah, but wouldn't dance. Yeah, I would have stayed on my knees and I sure wouldn't have danced with the devil. Jeez. Okay. Like, I just made reference to that from, she said, praying. But maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. I'm just clicking it in my brain. And my mother accused me of losing my mind, but I... Yeah, dating a 19-year-old, dating like a 30-year-old something. Yeah, and now that she's 30, oof, yeah. I can, you know what, let's just keep going. I was fine. You paint me a blue sky, then go back and turn it to rain. So, painting a blue sky, just making correlations to would've, could've, should've, but if I was some paint, did it splatter on a promising grown man? I just kind of linked it back to that, I guess, to do with paint. But I'm just kind of linking this song to would've, could've, should've, even though there's no connection, because my brain thoughts. And I lived in your chess game, but you changed the rules every day. Oof. Like, now I understand that better as a grown-up woman. So that's sort of like more of a relationship of whether you're happy or you're, the other person's happy or sad or whatever. Tonight, will I stop picking up, and this song is to let you know why. Oof. Yeah. I see it all now that you're gone. It feels right in the heart, you know what I mean? Like, because if would've, could've, should've. Oof. Yeah. Oof, that's Dear John. Oof. I don't know what to think of that. Like, I think that really hits me now at 22, not as a 10-year-old, but, like, that I know all the shit that John Mayer put her through and all that because of woulda, coulda, should've, and just her dating toxic men, I guess. Well, I mean, okay, Taylor Lautner's okay, Harry Styles is okay, but the rest, like Jake Gyllenhaal and who else has she dated? Besides John Mayer and Jake Gyllenhaal. I don't know, who cares? Like, they just all kind of screwed her over, if you know what I mean. Okay, Mean. This song I played a lot as a child because bullying and harassment was my comfort song, if you know what I mean. Like, that I'm not alone in life and that all they're ever gonna be is mean. Sorry for the reference, but yeah. It really helps me through a lot of shit. Of Us. Now, the original version, I never really liked it because she kind of sounded not bad, but she kind of sounded bored with it. Like, she kind of sounded like she didn't really want to sing it, if that makes sense. Like, it just had that feeling of ugh. Ugh, I really don't want to go and search up the non-original.
Sparks flew instantly.
See, it,
people would say they're the lucky ones.
See, she kind of feels like not putting enough emphasis in it. Like, she's kind of very flat about it. See, like, she's more emphasis in it, if that makes sense.
How we met and the sparks flew instantly.
See, more emphasis. I don't know. I just feel that way, that she put more emphasis in this one of the re-recording than the original. But anyway.
People would say they're the lucky ones. I used to know my place was the spot next to you. Now I'm searching the room for an empty seat. Cause lately I don't even know what page you're on.
Oof.
Oh, a simple complication. Miscommunications. Mm.
That is true.
So many things that I wish you knew.
That is so true, though. Like, miscommunication and complications do lead to fallouts. Talk to people. Like, don't bottle up your... Actually, I'm guilty of this, bottling up my feelings until they explode. So, I can't really say anything, I guess.
Walls up, I can't break through. Now I'm standing alone in a crowded room.
Yeah.
Next chapter.
Huh, next chapter. Cool. I kind of liked that. Oh, never grow up. Here's the next one. Okay. As a child, I never really wanted to grow up, but as a child, I had to grow up faster than most children. I didn't really have a... I mean, I had an okay childhood, I guess. Family issues, I'd rather not go into detail, but, like... Oof. It's gonna make me cry, probably.
Your little hands wrapped around my finger and it's so quiet in the world tonight.
Yep.
Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite night light.
Oof.
To you, everything's funny.
Yep.
You got nothing to regret.
Yes, as a kid you got nothing to regret, that is true.
Give all I have, honey. You could stay like that.
Yeah, I wish I could be a kid again with no responsibilities.
Oh, darling, don't you ever grow. Don't you ever grow.
Ah.
just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow. Don't you ever grow.
Oh, someone's on vocals. On the background vocals, anyway.
Stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you.
Yeah, backup vocals.
Won't let no one break your heart. And no one will desert you.
Too late for that.
Just try to never grow up.
Too late for that. People have deserted me. Anyway, that's not the point.
Never grow up.
I kind of like the plucky guitar. Basically, it's about mortality and don't forget about your parents and just... It's really sad, especially now that I've lost a parent. I kind of know just little things. Anyway. Oh, Enchanted! Oh my god, yes! One of my favorites as a kid too was Enchanted. Plucky guitar. I'm pretty sure it's different, but whatever. I don't really care. Once again tonight, I sing after faking smiles. Me, when I'm at a party or whatever. Anyway, continue. I know how that feels.
Walls of insincerity,
yep.
Shifting eyes in vacancy.
See, again, I can relate to a lot of these songs now that I'm more grown up. As a 10-year-old, I didn't really relate to these songs as much. But now that, as a 22-year-old woman, I relate to these songs a lot more. Well, I mean, other than Better Than Revenge and Mean, I mean.
Vanished when I saw your face. All I can say is it was enchanting to meet you. Your eyes whispered, have we met? Across the room, your silhouette starts to make its way to me.
It's just so different.
A playful conversation starts, counter all your quick remarks, like passing notes in secrecy.
Oof.
And it was enchanting to meet you.
Ooh, Troy's got you.
All I can say is I was enchanted to meet you.
Oh, I love the drums. Oh my god, Wonderstruck. Yes, it'd be amazing if she re-released the perfume of Wonderstruck. Oh, that'd be amazing. Vocals. Okay, that was Enchanted. Ah, love the vocals. Also, just in general, this is just giving me so much nostalgia from when I was a child. Okay, Better Than Revenge. Now, I know about the lyric change, okay? I get why she did it. Because basically, in the old version, it was basically slut-shaming, and she's been through a lot of shit like that. I get that, and I respect that as a woman. I kind of respect that. She would change lyrics. I don't know what she's changed it to, but I know that she's changed the lyrics because there was so much uproar on the internet about it.
Now go stand in the corner and think about what you did.
Yes! Like, I think it's just going to be out there forever. We're gonna have the homophobic version of Picture to Burn and Better Than Revenge slut shaming one, I guess, just never being released. Although maybe she could release them in the future, who knows. It's like that it's like Paramore. She said she wouldn't sing that one song or something, and then she never sang it for ages, and then like 13 years or something had passed, and then she ended up singing it again. So maybe Taylor might change her mind and I don't know, re-record Better Than Revenge, kind of slut-shaming edition, in brackets. I don't know, who knows? I hope they update lyrics. Sabotage. I'm not sure about this, but I'm thinking that's about Nick Jonas. Because we did get Mr. Perfectly Fine and Don't You. He was a moth to the flames. She was holding the matches. That's actually pretty good. Lyric change, not gonna lie. Okay. Anyway, that's interesting. Okay, Innocent Oof is another one.
I guess you really did it this time.
Yeah.
Left yourself in your war pie. Lost your balance on a tightrope.
That's funny. Sorry, that's just nothing to do with Taylor. It's just apparently I've seen pictures of Harry in his new music video, which I will do a reaction to, but apparently he falls off a tightrope or something, so that's why I just had that in my mind. I've seen the gif of him falling off the tightrope.
Lost your mind trying to get it back.
Been there. Done that.
Wasn't it easier in your lunchbox days?
Yes.
Always a bigger bed to crawl into.
Yeah.
Wasn't it beautiful when you believed in everything? And everybody
yes.
believed in you.
Who you are is not where you've been. I kind of like the lyrics, yeah.
Still an innocent.
Oh, I'm far beyond innocent. I think I lost that when I discovered what smut was. I was about, 11 or 12 when I discovered what smut was, so.
You're still an innocent.
Not anymore, no, God, no.
Can't speak of.
I've done a lot of things that I regret, but okay.
But at night you live it all again.
Did some things you can't speak of, but at night you live it all again. I kind of what's the next one? Haunted. Oof. Well, I think that's really different. I don't know. We'll see.
When I walk a fragile line,
friends drifting apart and just relationships of friendships not working out. Like, I can relate to this now as I said, as a 22-year-old rather than a 10-year-old. But anyway. Yeah. Oof, I can't trust anything now. Yeah. Yep. Ugh. Yeah, stood there watching you walked away from everything we had, but still mean every word I said to you. Oh, that just hits so deep, especially when I've had friends who backstab me and stuff. It just, I don't know, I can relate to this now that she's re-recorded it a lot more, is what I'm trying to say, than when I was like, you know, a carefree 10-year-old. Last kiss. Again, I think it's different production or whatever, but whatever. I don't really care.
I still remember the look on your face.
Yep.
Lit through the darkness.
At 158.
The words that you whispered for just us to know. You told me you loved me. Why did you go?
That's just really sad. You told me you loved me, and why did you go away? I can relate to that. Like, someone told me, yeah, you're my best friend, and I'll never, you know, leave you, and then they left, so. But then they also backstabbed me as well, so. Yeah. So again, I can relate to that.
Pavement, I ran off the plane. That July 9th, the beat of your heart, it jumps through.
July 9th. Oof.
Sir, yep. I can still feel your arms, but now I'll go sit on the floor wearing your clothes. All that I know is I don't know how to be someone.
I don't know who the backup vocals are, but that's like, I like the harmony of the backup vocals. I don't remember this song being so sad and cynical, almost. Maybe again, as a 10-year-old, I didn't really pay attention too much. Huh. Now I need to rethink of everything. Okay, I can't handle anymore. That's really depressing. All right, long live. Ah, sorry. Just thinking about that now, like, long live. Anyway.
I said, remember this moment.
In the back of my mind. Oh my god, yes.
The time we stood with our shaking hands, the crowds in stands went wild.
Who's this about?
And they read off our names.
Yeah, but who's she talking about in this song? I don't know. Anyway.
The night you danced like you knew our lives would never be the same. You held your head like a hero. On a history book page.
Okay, yeah. What's the end of a decade? Okay, so that must have been about 2010. So, yeah, going into 2011. Okay.
But the start of an age.
Maybe. I don't know. Long live the world we crashed through. Yes.
We will be remembered. I said remember.
Yeah. Woo. Hang on. Ours is next. This kind of feels different now that she's re-recording her albums as well. Like, I feel like that we as fans helped her reclaim our music, so everything is ours in a way. I don't know, I just feel that way. And this video is gonna be probably an hour long anyway. We'll see.
Elevator buttons and morning air.
I don't remember this.
Stranger silence makes me wanna take the stairs.
That is so true in life though. Oof. Although we don't call it elevator, we call it lift. But anyway, that's not the point. Yeah, like, just stranger silence when you're in the lift or with somebody and they don't...
If you were here, we'd laugh about their vacant stairs. But right now, my time is theirs. Seems like there's always someone who disapproves.
Oof. Yes.
They'll judge it like they know about me and you.
I think that's everybody judging her for her dating choices. Oh yeah, she did date what's his name from 75 or whatever the band, Matt Hardy or whatever. He's still a racist prick. But you know, whatever.
And the verdict comes from those with nothing else. Jury's out. My choice is you. So don't you worry your pretty little mind.
Love the backup vocals. Anyway.
Things that shine in life makes love look hard. The stakes are high. The water's rough. But this love is ours.
I think this is more going back to people being judgmental. It seems like there's always someone to disapprove. I guess, in a way, yeah, there's someone always gonna disapprove of her choices. Or I think, just in general, not just to Taylor, but I think in life, that someone's gonna, like, disapprove of your choices. In a way. Like, they judge you, like, they know you, but they don't. Like, wow. I'm surprised I didn't actually relate to that as a kid. Okay, next is Superman.
Tall, dark, and Superman. He puts papers in his briefcase and drives away to save the world or go to work. It's the same thing to me. He's got his mother's eyes, his father's ambition.
Who's this written about? I have no idea. Anyway.
Wonder if he knows how much that I miss him. I hang on.
I'll be here on the ground when you come back down. Sorry, I can just relate that to I knew you were trouble. Jesus Christ. Yeah, now I'm lying on the cold, hard ground. I knew you were trouble, trouble. Like, just going back to that, I guess, in a way. I don't know. Now we have From the Vault. I'm excited for the Vault tracks. So the first one, we have Electric Touch featuring Fall Out Boy. But, like, as a child, I also liked Fall Out Boy. I think I discovered them when I was, like, 13. Whoa. Okay. That's kind of poppy. Kind of. I love it. It's kind of. You can bop along to it. I'm gonna definitely need the lyrics. Love the music production. Love the piano and the drums. Just breathe. Okay. How about to your cars in the driveway? Ooh. Okay. Just now until your car's in the driveway. Just the first time ever hanging out with you. I wonder who this is about.
Time ever hanging out with you tonight.
Okay.
I've got my money on things going badly. Got a history of stories and exact.
So Taylor Lautner and John Mayer, okay.
Still hoping that the fire won't burn me. Just one time. Just one time.
Okay.
All I know is this could either break my
heart or bring it to life. So this must have been after her breakup with John Mayer then. Maybe, I don't know. Ooh, I like that. Could fill this ghost town up with life.
Ghost town up with life. And I want here now. Wanna need you forever.
The heat of your electric touch. Also, I pointed out there's a reference to this song apparently. In the I Can See You music video. Anyway. Sorry, just jump scare. That really jump scared me. Let's just go back a bit so I'm prepared. I've been left in the rain, lost and pining. Been there.
Trying hard not to look like
been there.
Trying. 'Cause every time I tried hard for love, it fell apart.
Yeah, been there. Got used to no one calling my phone. Yep, been there.
I'm sleeping alone.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's just one time.
Just
one time.
Break my heart or bring it back to life. Ooh, I love it. Just love it. This is probably one of my best. Maybe this is one of the best Vault tracks so far. Besides, I Can See You, obviously. Ooh. Okay. I would say, can it just one time? Just one.
All you mine, and you won't need space, but string me along while you decide. And just one,
wait, hold up. 8:05, and I see headlights. 1 hour until your car's in the driveway at the beginning, and 8:05. Hang on, because I'm pretty sure Jonas Brothers have a song. Yeah, the Jonas Brothers have a song, 7:05. Oh my god. This is totally about Nick Jonas. We're getting a Vault track about Nick Jonas, but to be fair, we did also get a Vault track about Nick Jonas, Mr. Perfectly Fine, so. Clever. clever. Ooh. Ooh, pitch vocals. I like that. When Emma falls in love. Okay.
When Emma falls in love, she paces the floor, okay. Closes the blinds and locks the door. When Emma falls in love, she calls up her mom, jokes about the ways that this one could go wrong. She waits and takes her time, cause little Miss Sunshine always thinks it's gonna rain.
Isn't that reference to Easy A, maybe? In the shower scene or whatever? Playing like Little Miss Sunshine. Never mind. Don't worry about it.
When Emma falls in love, I know that boy will never be the same.
Okay.
She's the kind of boy that you can't put down.
Okay. Cleopatra grew up in a small town. Okay. And bad boys would be good.
Ooh.
Okay. Okay.
When Emma falls in love, it's all on her face, hangs in the air like stars in outer space.
I kind of like that lyric. When Emma falls in love, it's all on her face, hangs in the air like stars in outer space. That's kind of cool. Oh, New York. Okay.
When she's in LA,
ooh, good to know.
She won't lose herself in love the way that I did.
Ooh, yeah.
Cause she'll call you.
She won't lose herself in love the way I did. Is she talking about John Mayer or something? Anyway, let's continue.
She puts you in your place. When Emma falls in love, I'm learning.
Okay. But that's interesting. So she kind of wishes she was like Emma, taking love lessons, I guess. Now, I'm going to skip this because I did the music video reaction to this. If you haven't, go and see it. I'll link it in the description or put it in the icon. Now, next one after that is Castles Crumbling featuring Hayley Williams. Ah, Paramore! I'm also pissed off because I didn't get tickets to go and see Paramore coming here as well. So, anyway. Okay, so it's very fairy tale themed, almost. Okay.
Once I had an empire in a golden age.
So fearless, I'm assuming. Maybe.
I was held up so high, I used to be great. They used to cheer when they saw my face. Now
oh,
I fear I have fallen from grace.
Oh.
And I feel like my castle's crumbling down, and I watch all my bridges
so sad.
Burn to the ground, and you
don't want to know me. I'll just let you down.
I will just let you down. You don't wanna know me now.
Holy shit, that's sad. But what in what situation?
Once I was the great hope, okay. For a dynasty.
Hayley Williams first.
Crowds would hang on my words and they trusted me. Faith was strong, but I pushed it too far. I held that grudge.
Oh, jeez.
Till it tore me apart. Power went to my head.
Oh, jeez.
And I couldn't stop.
Oh. levels of regret. Oh, Jesus Christ. Falling down like promises that it... Like promises that I never kept. Jesus Christ. This is really depressing. Is this about... This must have been about Kanye. You know, the VMA speech. Like, she felt so betrayed, maybe? Like, because she did say... Once I had an empire in a golden age, so fearless. Like, she was high up on the pedestal. But, like, everyone else just doesn't want to know her anymore. Because she feels like she's going to let them down. Because... she feels so depressed about it? I don't know. I have no idea. Huh. Pose and friends, okay. My brain end? Honey. Speak Now, 2010 era. Yeah, so this must have been like... Because she did... She said she wrote Speak Now when she was on Fearless tour. So, yeah. Must have been about the VMAs. Or whatever. I feel like she's losing control, I guess, in a way. Ooh. You're not a monster! So yeah, this has to be with Kanye, the beef with Kanye. And the VMAs, because everyone's like, oh my god, she... And, you know, that actually happened again when Harry was going to collect his award or whatever for Album of the Year or some award, and yeah, someone shouted, oh yeah, you don't... Beyonce should have won instead or whatever, and then Taylor kind of felt bad for him, I guess, in a way, so they started talking after he he came down from the stairs, and then they kind of sat together and started talking to each other, which is kind of cool. But yeah, put it this way, every artist deserves an award because they put in the work. Okay, you can't just say, oh yeah, you don't deserve the award, someone else does. Like, they just worked, like, they worked just as hard as that person for the award, whether it's like, you know, VMAs or Brit Awards or whatever award it is, Grammys or whatever. But like, yeah, you can't just, like, I think it's disrespectful in saying that, you know, oh, you know, this person deserves award and not this person and stuff, or just interrupting people's speeches in general is really disrespectful. But then yeah, Kanye is just still a dick in general, so. But oh, this is so depressing. Never wanted you to hate me. Jesus. And then the voice breaks. Yeah, I think it just repeats itself, yeah. That's really depressing, but I do love it. I'm not gonna lie, but it's really depressing. But again, I can also relate to it. Damn it. Foolish One. Check it out. On the table. Yours are in your hand. Oh my god, okay. Chances are tonight you've already got plans. And chances are I will talk myself to sleep again. Oof. Jesus, about a relationship not going well. I'll talk myself to sleep again. Oh, Jesus Christ, yeah. You give me just enough attention so to keep my hopes up too high. Is this about Nick Jonas again? Like, because they were kind of like on the fringes, weren't they? Like, on again, off again, or was that someone else with Nick Jonas? Anyway, never mind. Wishful thoughts forget to mention when something's really not right, and I will block out these voices of reason in my head. Yeah, when you're in love, you don't want to see when the relationship is crashing. Like, you don't want to admit that the relationship is crashing, I guess. And the lyric, I'll block out these voices of reason in my head. Yeah, like, when my friendship was kind of on the fritz, kind of, because it was kind of on again, off again, kind of, friendship, yeah, I guess I never really wanted to listen to my subconscious. It's like, oh my God, you should dump this person as a friend because they're so toxic or whatever, you know, kind of thing. I didn't really want to admit that, I guess, in a way. Huh, interesting.
And the voices say you are not the exception. You will never learn your lesson. Foolish one, stop checking your mailbox for confessions of love that ain't never gonna come. You will take the long way. You will take the long way down. You know how to keep me waiting. I know how to act like I'm fine. Don't know what to call this situation, but I know I can't call you mine. And it's
I don't know what to call this situation, but I can't call you mine. And then that kind of reminds me of All Too Well. He's going to say it's love, but you never called it what it was. Like, it just kind of reminds me of that. Anyway.
Because when my head is on your shoulder, it starts thinking you'll come around. And maybe someday when we're older, this is something we'll laugh about. Over coffee every morning while you're watching the news.
Now I'm sliding down the wall.
And the voices in my head are telling me why. Cause you got her on your arm and me in the wings. I'll get your longing glances.
But she'll get your ring. So I'm assuming this is Nick Jonas, maybe? Ooh.
But she'll get your.
Cause better than revenge. She's got your. Never mind.
And you will say you had the best of intentions.
Interesting.
Foolish was
sitting around and waiting for a love impression of love. Gonna come. Oof. Oof. Getting out. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. Foolish one, the day is gonna come
for your confessions of love. When all is said and done, he just wasn't the one.
But the last one is timeless. Okay. Interesting. Guitar stripped back.
Down the block there's an antique shop, and something in my head said stop. So I walked in. On the counter was a cardboard box, and the sign said photos 25 cents each. Black and white, saw a 30s bride and two lovers slapping on the porch of the first house. The kind of love that you only find once in a lifetime. The kind you don't put down.
Okay.
And that's when I called you, and it's so hard to explain, but in those photos I saw us instead.
Oh.
Even if we'd been on a crowded street in 1944. Ooh. And you were headed off to fight in the war. Ooh. You still would have been mine. We would have been timeless.
Okay.
I would have read your love letters every.
That's interesting. Even if we met on a crowded street in 1944 and you had to head off to the war. Yeah, because 1945 was World War One, wasn't it? Huh, interesting. Okay. I would have read your love letters every single night and prayed to God you'd be coming home all right. Interesting.
I prayed to God you'd be coming home all right, and you would have been fine. We would have been timeless.
So it's basically saying that we would have been, like, we would still be okay, I guess. Like, anyway, timeless.
I believe that we were supposed to find
yeah, sort of like fate. Yes. So fate. All that. Interesting. Was one of a teenage couple in the driveway, holding hands on the way to a dance, and the date on the back said 1958, which brought me back to the first time I saw you. Time stood still like something in this old shop. If I first saw your face in the 1500s off in a foreign land, and I was forced to marry another man. So Romeo and Juliet. Love story. Huh, interesting. Still would have been mine, we would have been timeless. Even in a different life, so even if you still would have been mine. Yeah. So even in a different life, you would still be mine. We would have been timeless. Jesus Christ, this quote also just reminds me, for no particular reason, probably because the other day, I rewatched My Policeman. Kind of reminds me of that, and just, if it was set in a different time period, would they still be together kind of thing. It just, anyway, yeah, that is the whole entire album of Speak Now's Taylor's version. Just bring back so many memories and childhood experiences, I guess. Well, now I'm just gonna go and re-listen to all those songs now and contemplate about childhood, I guess. But no, I hope you enjoyed this video, whatever it turns out to be. It's probably gonna be an hour long or something. I'll try and cut it down. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.